Crazy Rosie calls Trump mentally unstable as the sick secret she's hiding comes out. Crazy Rosie O'Donnell is completely unhinged after dedicating almost every waking moment to her one-woman crusade to stop President Donald Trump, and it looks like she has finally cracked. Giving an interview to W Magazine, Rosie says the president is mentally unstable. However, she is hiding a sick secret that she did not want anyone to know, but to her dismay, it's coming out, and you don't want to miss this. During the presidential campaign and Donald Trump's time in office, Rosie O'Donnell has called the president everything from mentally unstable to sadistic. In January, Rosie said she supports martial law to prevent Trump's inauguration. She is an avid fan of Rachel Maddow and has bought hook, line, and sinker every conspiracy the MSNBC host has sold. That alone, watching MSNBC every night, would cause mental instability, so when Rosie said she was breaking her silence, it turned to some crazy topics. The day after the election, Rosie had a huge acting job, and it was really important. Apparently, she was shooting a pilot, and the show was not picked up for TV. She blames Trump, of course, because she was in shock and suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder. The reason I thought we were not picked up was because I was really bad in the pilot because I was in shock. I was in pure unadulterated shock, as if I had fallen through the ice on a lake. I was underneath the water and I couldn't even see the surface. It was a severe shock to my entire essence and my beliefs in the order in the world, and also the PTSD of having been an abused kid in a family. And to think that the man who had abused me so viciously and with impunity for over a decade was now running the country, Rosie recalled, according to W Magazine. Rosie wasn't done there with the dramatics. No, like any good liberal and Trump hater, she is fearing for her life if Trump is president for a whole 4 years. There are people who tell me, oh, it's going to be another year, another 2 years, and I seriously worry whether I personally will be able to live through his presidency, and whether the nation will be able to live through it and survive, O'Donnell said in the interview with W Magazine. So, Rosie, in her first interview since the election, has made a pretty good case for her immediate admission into a psyche ward. No joke. Rosie's Trump delusion is strong and not based on any facts. Feeding herself MSNBC every night has caused her to really become very delusional and unstable. Either she is lying and doing a great acting job, or she has really lost it. Here is another strange statement from Rosie's W Magazine interview that shows she really needs mental help. She said, I remember that night before they were announcing who had won, I saw the Trump children with their children on TV, and they were on an Instagram or something. They were taking a video going, Grandpa's gonna be the president. I literally felt such sorrow inside of me that these people were so deluded. What were they doing with this child to tell the baby their grandfather's going to be president? Wow. Telling your child their grandfather is about to become the president is not delusional. He did become president. What are they deluded about? Rosie assigns character traits to Trump which she is mimicking from the hardcore leftist media. What she doesn't know is that they don't even believe what they are saying about Trump. It's a big game to them. Rosie actually thinks Trump is worse than Adolf Hitler. Her sick secret is that she is the one who is quite delusional, especially when it comes to her obsession with President Donald Trump. So, we have to conclude that Trump derangement syndrome is a real thing, not just a joke. What is scarier is how the mainstream media pushes these gullible people into believing anything. Here's hoping Rosie O'Donnell gets some help.